Hello students, this is Professor Krochmal. We're in Newark Airport. Welcome to ICM 501. Here we go.
Hello students, this is Professor Krochmal. This week, we'll be talking about what makes videos viral, stickiness, and spreadability.
By way of review, this is learning module number 4 last week. We talked about the global digital village, social revolution and change, online megaphones. And then the week before that, we began things off by taking a look at the evolution or the revolution of technology over time into the digital age and the rapid rise of new technologies changing how we communicate and changing mass communication.
This week, we'll start things off by taking a look at the very first TV-fueled fad. Then we'll be exploring virality. We'll have some video. And then we'll take a look at the terms that you should understand and should be familiar with as going forward.
Born on a mountaintop in Tennessee, green estate in the land of the free. Raised in the woods so he knew every tree. Killed him a bar when he was only 3. Davy, Davy Crockett, king of the wild frontier.
Davy, Davy Crockett. I love it.
It was the first time I brought an invention to school to show to a teacher.
In early September, Ahmed Muhammad, a teenager in Texas, brought a homemade clock to school. Somebody got upset, thought it was a bomb, called the cops, and Ahmed Muhammad was arrested. After coverage of it came out in the media, Ahmed Muhammad became an internet sensation. He went viral.
Bill Wasik is an editor at Wired Magazine, and when he talks about going viral, and he's been associated with the term going viral now for about 20 years, I think it's not the quantity of attention, but the speed of it, he says.
Making stuff that's viral is really just about making stuff that causes conversation that sort of hooks into social processes and why people talk to one another. So on some level, it's possible to engineer it, but on another level, the way you engineer it is just by doing the things that those of us who have, on some level, that those of us who sort of like express ourselves for a living have always done, which is try to make stuff that that people are interested in. It's somewhat more complicated than that. The technology does lead to certain, you know, aesthetic values or certain sort of things being more, more popular in an internet age than they might have been in an offline age. But nevertheless, the basic principle still applies.
This is a chart that shows two models of dispersion. On the left, you have the broadcast model, one to many. On the right, you have the viral model, where it's 1 to 2 to 4, and it keeps going and going, or it doesn't. Any one place where you have a branch, content can stop there. So if you want to understand social media, look in the lower branches here, and that's where things are starting to really get interesting, and this gets replicated and replicated. But only if the content is something that people would want to share. They make the decision to share it, and that's how things go viral. But don't fear this. It's an equation, and some of you who are mathematically inclined understand it's a way to represent the universe and science. And you know, if you remember your high school algebra, the equation has to be equivalent on both sides of the equal sign. So I won't bother, and I probably cannot explain this to you, but essentially the formula says the average distance between each person that spreads a piece of content from creator to each person that clicks a share. And so you plug the values in here and you get a graph. So a Yahoo story with 1 million views but isn't shared is not viral, while a BuzzFeed story that may not have as many views but is widely shared is measurably viral.
So people come to me all the time, like they want to make viral videos. This is going to be really depressing. You want to make a viral video? Don't. Don't even try. It is too hard. It is way too hard. Let me give you some numbers to show you how hard it is. The content on our sites, let's say our audience creates, freeze the math, 40,000 pieces of content per week. We have learned a lot about how to increase the probability of getting content to go viral, and we get one of those 40,000 pieces of content to go viral per week on average. And when I say viral, I also mean, you know, millions of people viewing it viral. So in short, viral coefficient, something you need to know. If the viral coefficient is above one, that's when you start getting exponential growth. There's ways you can increase the viral coefficient. Viral coefficient just means for every one person who sees it, how many people do they bring with them? How many people do they refer? So above one means on average they refer more than one person for every person who sees it. The more incentive you give people to share, the more likely they are to share. Now that sounds like one of those really obvious things, and you know, and you're probably thinking, well, okay, duh. But it's one of those things, if you really think about it, you think about the implications of it, there's much more to it than that. So there's two basic strategies you can get people to share. Ultimately, virality is just word of mouth marketing, but the online version of it. The first strategy, this is the strategy I tell everyone to use, bribery. It's the most effective strategy. It's really straightforward. You give somebody something in return for doing something you want. As aggressive as you think you could be in the most aggressive situation that you'd ever think that you'd be willing to do that, be five times more aggressive than that, because most people are just way too scared to ask for referrals. Things that, if you want to make something go viral, you need to piss people off or make them really happy, but nothing in between.
Media creates value and meaning as it travels across the culture. The companies that seek to lock down and restrict our access to their content devalue it, lose out on the rich and robust conversations that are going on all around it. That our central message is if it doesn't spread, it's dead. Where our awareness of things are shaped by our friends, family members, spreading pieces of media to us and creating that initial contact and awareness of a new property. It's not the agency or the network that is pushing the content at that point, it's the consumer that's engaging other consumers with that content. So in the sense, spreadability is all about the choices we make as individuals, as community members, as parts of larger networks affecting the flow of media through the culture. So for example, the nonprofit organization Invisible Children releases Cooney 2012, expectation it's going to reach 500,000 viewers over a 2-month period of time, because that was the track record of previous content, 70 million in 4 days. Actually, if you took the highest rated film in the US that weekend, the highest grossing show on television that weekend, added them together, you still would get nowhere near the number of views that this human rights video got on YouTube. The scope of that absolutely dwarfs the capacity of broadcast media at the same time. Take a few zeros off, and then suddenly you're looking at those videos that get 70,000 as opposed to 70 million views, and many, many more of those that would never have gotten visibility under the old system. And you realize this is not something on the fringes. This is central to how the media ecology is going to work for the years to come. Viral is a metaphor, is really a dead end. You know, it's sick-making in a certain way, because it starts from this idea of infection, epidemics, susceptibility, vulnerability, and it doesn't actively acknowledge the agency of people who are choosing to pass content along. I mean, in the course of a day, we may get 100 pieces of media through our inbox, of all small percentage of which we choose to pass along. So we're making active decisions about what media to pass to what people, in which conversations, through which channels, with which messages attached, and whether we want to alter it in some fundamental way or not. And we can't really get there by either passively saying, I don't know what happened, it just went viral, or promising this occult science where a small number of experts can tell us how to make something go viral. Instead, we actually have to engage in the active social and cultural processes through which media.
Let's talk about a few other terms that you should know. This is sticky. What is sticky? It's content published on a website which entices a user to return and spend longer periods of time. Webmasters use this method to build up a community of returning visitors to a website, and also being able to measure these returns is an important aspect in terms of selling advertising.
Moment. One of them, as you mentioned, is sticky video. The idea is that the video player moves with you on the screen, so that rather than the traditional way of watching a video and then waiting for that to finish and reading the article, as you read down the article, the video will follow you down, and obviously the advertising follows with the video, so it's very immersive, and it reflects much more about how people are consuming content, that they're not just traditionally watching a video and then reading a piece of content. It's truly kind of seamless, and that's the idea behind that one.
Richard Dawkins really identified the idea. He came up with the term meme, and it's more than a picture with text on it. Memes are ideas that spread throughout a culture. They can be ideas, tunes, images, and So in 1976, 43 years ago, Richard Dawkins wrote this about the emergence of memes. I think that a new kind of replicator has recently emerged on this very planet. It is staring us in the face. It is still in its infancy, still drifting clumsily about in its primeval soup, but already it is achieving evolutionary change at a rate that leaves the old gene panting far behind. So he's referencing biology, but it's really about these intangible things that he calls a meme that are spread from person to person throughout the culture. Let's take a look at the last two things that we want to talk about is the network effect and the long tail. Now, the network effect, you can recall from the first week where we talked about a fax machine and whether a fax machine is value on its own, and it isn't. Your Amazon not only can sell the best, most popular things, but it can also keep very easily and let you buy those things like books that are out of print, things that aren't necessarily hit, but there will be a little bit of demand over a long time. So for the week, you've got a couple things to do that are kind of complicated, so make sure you read the learning module in Blackboard to have it right, but you can write a proposal outlining the strategy of a viral video campaign. What could be more fun? Then, tell me who the audience is, what is the message and the focus of the video, and what content would be featured, and then how would you measure success? You must have references, okay? Additionally, research and identify two viral campaigns. What should be a commercial viral campaign created by an advertiser or an organization trying to use viral to spread their message? The second should be an organic or accidental viral event, not the Harlem Shake. I probably can guess which one many of you will use, but impress me, all right? Document the campaign in terms of origins, use of media, rate of spread, and if possible, what was the outcome? Did the campaign work? How and why? Be prepared to defend your ideas. Create a video presentation using screenshots to describe the campaign and walk us through the points above. And tweet the videos you choose to ICM501 on Twitter. And we'll talk to you next week. As always, I'm available on email. If you want to schedule a Skype or a Hangout, I am available. Let's talk. Goodbye. In early September, Ahmed Mohammed, a teenager in Texas, brought a homemade clock to school. Somebody got upset, thought it was a bomb, called the cops, and Ahmed Mohammed was arrested. After coverage of it came out in the media, Ahmed Mohammed became an internet sensation. He went viral, and people came to his rescue at the highest levels, the White House, Mark Zuckerberg, even Twitter. You can look at the chart and you can see a spike graph of going viral.